Little child, I tell you, arise. These are the words that we hear today in the Gospel. After last Sunday, we saw Jesus give order to the wind and water. As he calmed the sea and the wind, he showed his manifestation of his divinity that he has over nature. And today, he showed another sign of his very reality, Son of God, by even order death to diminish, to take away from this little child. And again, this child comes to life. In order to understand the mystery of death, we have to go to the first reading. And in the first reading today, taking from the Book of Wisdom, we saw and we read that God is not the author of death. And so the question comes, who is the author of death? And I want to walk you through, and you will come to understanding why that Book of Wisdom say those words. In the early days, when God, before even creating the heaven and earth, he revealed to his spirits around him, his angels, that after he will create, and after he will create the masterpiece of all creation, in fact, he is going to create them on his own image, there is going to be a fall due to sin. And God was about to restore that sin by becoming human. And the angels, when they hear that, they were very, very astonished. And Lucifer said to God, "Non-servo. I will not serve you. I will never lower myself to worship a human who is less than me." And God knows that this was going to be the fall of the angels. And there was a separation in heaven. The good and those who are less good, we call them the bad angels. And that is the beginning of the death. With that jealousy in his heart, because God did not give him a second chance, because as an intelligent spirit, he knows what God can do, but he never allowed God to do what he intended to do. Comparing to the humanity, because of the weakness of nature that the devil has put jealousy and envy against, we know that God not only forgive, but he intend to send his son to be the redeemer of that human nature. And we know that then, by that very sin, death entered the world. In fact, St. Paul in the Romans, not today, but to St. Paul said that by one man, sin entered the world, and sin occurred death. And because of that, all of us who come in the flesh, we experience it in our flesh. So we are not speaking about the physical death, but we are going to speak now about the spiritual death. And that's why in the first reading today, you hear the conclusion of that reading by saying, "But the envy of the devil, death entered the world, and they who belong to his company experience it." In other words, we who, because of our fragility of nature and because of our pride, choose to do evil, we are in the company of the evil one. And because of that, we experience our spiritual death. Unless there is a conversion and return to the truth. In the Gospel today, we find two miracles that Jesus did. The first miracle is of the woman who for 12 years was experienced hardship in her body. And because of that, she was wasted her money, wasted all her saving at the hands of the doctors, and still she did not get well. In fact, the Gospel said she got worse. And she thought to herself, now this is faith, if I only touch the clothes, the garment of the Master, I will be healed. And with that faith, she went from behind and touched his garment. At that very moment, healing came to her. And Jesus, to make sure that this healing will be, as we say, recorded, he said to his apostles, "Who touched me?" And we know the answer, "Lord, look at these hundreds of people hemming on you, and you say, who touched me?" And the woman who knows what took place, she came prostrate in front of Jesus, confessed the whole truth, and Jesus said to her, "Your faith has been your healing. Your faith has been your salvation." As Jesus was speaking at that very moment, from the official house a word came. And they said to the official, "Jairus, why are you bothering the master to come to the house to cure your daughter? Your daughter just died." If we look at the evangelist Matthew, he said to us, it was 1 p.m. And that phrase was put there just to remind us that the very time that Jesus assured Jairus not to be afraid, but just with faith. At that very moment, Jesus was asking that daughter is going to come to live, is going to live. And he said to Jairus, "Disregard the report, you just have faith." He comes to the house and he finds commotion and people wailing. Remember, although this Jairus was an officer of the Romans, he was very inclined to the Jewish people. He built them their synagogues and he was very, very, as we say, popular among them. And so they were sad that this young child of his, 12 years old, had experienced this hardship of sickness and reached her to death. And Jesus said to them, "Why are you wailing? What is this commotion? The daughter is not, the child is not dead, but asleep." They all begin making fun of him. He took Peter, James, and John, and his brother, and went in with the mother and father, and he said to the young girl, "Talitha kum." That means, "Little daughter, little child, get up." I know how to pronounce those words, because those are Semitic. The qualification of my language, where I come from, is Tfilin, um. Is equal to that word because the roots of our language is there. And I know exactly what Jesus was trying to indicate by those words, that he is the author of life and he can stop even the mystery of death because he comes to heal and to restore.